The Finance Minister Arun Jaitley recently clarified that the lower tax liability in real estate should lead to price reduction. The price reduction has to be passed on to the customer. This is what the Finance Minister has said. These were his words. But there are complaints from homeowners that those who have booked flats and made part payments are being asked to make an entire payment before July 1st, 2017 or to face higher tax incidence for payment made thereafter. Now, how true this is or how valid this is, to discuss this, we have with us Om Ahuja, CEO Residential Brigade Group, and we also have with us Ankit Gulgulia Jain. He's Chartered Accountant of Ankit Gulgulia and Associates. Welcome to the show, gentlemen. Ankit, I'd like to start with you. Now, before we take Om's perspective into it, which is the developer's perspective, now, the Finance Minister is telling me that the prices are going down. Then why should a home buyer be paying an, should be paying an added extra money which the developers are demanding? Should I believe them and actually pay all my money before the rollout of GST, or should I wait?
See, Anjali, I personally believe that whatever is the benefit that is the GST regime is going to give, this is absolutely going to reduce it. But to the extent if you are going to generalize it over and every state that is operating in terms of builders, then that might not be the case. Potentially, if you see the construction also, the land cost typically where is higher, then in that case, the whole concept of this GST will be very, very less. So my view is that yes, the prices are going to be reduced, but offsetting the complete increase in the incidence might be not applicable in all the cases as such.
So the land cost is higher, you mean, where stamp duty is high, or these particular concerns will increase the price,
right?
You're saying.
Right. So in, say for example, I'll give you an example. Say talk about Haryana. Haryana right now faces, any buyer who is going to buy in Haryana is going to have 4.5% of service tax, right?
Yes.
Now 4.5% of service tax plus, if the developer is not under the composition scheme, then in that case we assume around 3 to 4% of additional liability in terms of VAT also.
Okay.
So that makes the tax incidence somewhere around 8%, right?
Yes.
If it is now 12%, then I assume that the differential 4% will be easily offset in terms of extra input that the developer is going to get. But if the developer, say for example, is under composition scheme where he is not supposed to collect 1%, then the total incidence that is passed to the customer is just 4.5% of service tax. Now that 12% right now and what is the 4.5% earlier, there is a differential gap of 7.5%. In my personal view, when you talk about 7.5% and offsetting it with that complete amount of SenVAT credit that will be newly now available to the developer, that might be a little difficult task.
Okay.
So I would say, to sum up this, 50 to 60% cases of developers which are operating at a mediocre level and a normal level and all, where the pricing is not very high and the construction component is comparatively higher, I assume the rates will be effectively reduced. Where the land costs are high or the areas are very posh, say golf course road or something, where the construction cost actually gets lesser income vis-a-vis the land cost,
yeah,
then in that case the effect will be lesser.
Okay, so Om, is that the only reason? Is only the land cost going to be the reason that you think that people won't be able to reduce the cost, or so people should pay up upfront and try and avoid that increased cost after GST?
Okay, Anjali, it's very simple. As explained by the other gentleman, it's very clear that, you know, every state has different taxation norms today. Every developer has different composite or non-composite form of paying, collecting tax. So it all depends upon the which state you are in, which developer are you dealing with. So let's say, for example, you have Tamil Nadu, you have Karnataka, you have Telangana. In Telangana today, it's beneficial for a customer to go and completely pay before the GST is introduced, because the tax incidence will actually go higher post GST implementation, because Telangana currently has a lower tax regime. Whereas in Karnataka, there will be a benefit to a customer ranging between 3 to 4%. So that there is, every state has its own terminology at this point of time, very difficult to generalize. But eventually what we see is, what finance minister or the government wants to basically bring in the anti-profiteering law, this will actually benefit a customer somewhere between 2 to 4%. That is the eventual benefit what customer will enjoy, but depends again which state, which developer are you dealing with.
Okay, so Om, what would you say, what kind of buyers should make a prepayment? You know, all buyers? Because it does not make sense for me to make a full payment ahead of 30th of June just because I just bought right now. Is there a certain category in those particular states that you are saying, like Telangana and all, where the all buyers should make that kind of a early payment?
Not really, Anjali. Hmm. For example, if the building is close to being giving OC, building is ready, maybe 2 months away, 3 months away, the OC is pending. In okay. those cases, makes a lot of sense if you are having self-funding. If you are having money lying in any other source of investment, you do pay up your so-called outstanding, you benefit better. But if you are dependent upon a bank loan will only be disbursed once you have a OC in hand, or maybe you have key in the hand, basically possession. Hmm. So no bank will disburse the loan until all the aspects are cleared under the so-called norms of the bank. But those cases, you cannot go and seek this part full payment now. Wherever you are self-funding, in a state like Telangana, it makes a lot of sense to immediately go and pay up the outstanding.
Okay. So, Ankit, what would you suggest?
And the building is close to being occupied.
Okay. So, Ankit, what would you suggest? What should a buyer do? As in, what could be my checklist to find out whether it is sensible for me to pay early or not? What should be my way of calculating that?
See, Anjali,
in simple terms.
Yes, in simple terms. Actually, in simple terms, I would say that it is a very tough mechanism. Admittedly, it's a tough mechanism because I believe that anti-profiteering being measured out in the clearest of senses will be very tough. You see the countries which have done it. Australia has done it. Malaysia has done it. Even they have faced a lot of administration issue. My personal observation for the buyers would be simple. In case if they are into those developers which are willing to basically put in some sort of a demarcation that, okay, this is the anti-profiteering reduction in prices that we are supposed to offer once the 1st of July implementation is going to come, they have to basically get in touch with the developer to get that percentage off the record. So what happens is, if you do not basically get an understanding as to how much reduction is going to come after 1st of July, you don't have any decision making parameter as such, right?
Yes.
So if I don't know how much is the reduction expected, how can I make a decision? So the first objective would be to approach the developer and understand it, to what extent they are having an assumption that the anti-profiteering will lead to a reduction in the prices. Till then, I feel that it will not be a clear thing to get into it right now.
Okay, so you would say that do your calculations well and then decide. Now, Om, what are you guys doing, or your people from your community, the developer community, what are you doing to educate the buyer or communicate this to him? Because it is a very complex thing.
So, Anjali, at this point of time, what we believe is there is a lot of newer challenges we'll be facing with regard to how you will see the credit come in, how you benefit with it. But yes, eventually what has to be done is our basic calculation, early calculations show somewhere between 2 to 4% is going to be the benefit. That is something which you would like to pass on. And again, time will tell. It's too little early. Let the things settle down. Government also has said you have 2 more months to file your first return in terms of GST. I think there are a lot of system challenges, implementation challenges, understanding challenges. As we speak, the consultant challenges, every consultant has a different view at this point of time on every aspect of it. So maybe over a period of 2 to 3 months, you may see a 2 to 4% benefit for every customer who is looking at buying home.
Okay. So, thank you so much, gentlemen, for joining in this discussion. So, one thing is clear to us, that do your math well, sit down with a chartered accountant, speak to your developer, find out how this is going to impact you, and then make your decision, because it's not an easy calculation to make, that much we will admit. Thank you so much for joining.